And it is in the first 1 and 2 to qualify for the next round. The first 1 and 2 that we qualify. And the position of our customer for the levels. Second position of 42. Horacio Favore of Italy. And in the yellow track suit, you see the Australian skate parents. Start, please. officially known as the chronic lion. That's Gooch. Made the Matsu. Chronic lion has moved now to race number 3, 1500 meters men. In a few moments we continue the program with race number 9. The third heat, 1500 meters men. And there are again 6 gainers on the track. From the United States, Eric Lane. From China, Yang Yongli. From Norway, Hjalmar Helgemo. From Australia, Stephen Bradbury. New Zealand, Mike McMillan. And Ukraine, Alexander Mikhailuka. Please prepare for the start.
From Hungary, that's 6:30.
Vancouver, Canada. Second place in the Unicorn of Australia, number 5, Richard Mazilti. Third place from Russia, 72, Sergey Kovacev.
Hold, Jimmy!
Now, changing the leadership. Takes the lead. Second place now, Frederick Blackwell, then Nizilski, Kovacev, and Kortmanic of Hungary in last place at the moment, but three skaters to qualify.
Very awesome. And this is not exactly his business because he's part of the
Thank you. So the men's 500 metres, this is the first heat, again, like the ladies, two to qualify for the quarterfinals. Fagoni, Italy, Hansen, Australia, Bartz, USA, and Kim Balint from Hungary. And the favorite is Fagoni from Italy. Fagoni tucks in second place. It's Bartz who leads. Fagoni second. Hansen third. Four and a half laps. A lap and a half gone, and it's Bartz. Here comes Fagoni on the outside. Fagoni, remember, who was fourth in the 1500 metres, and he makes his move now. Fagoni leads, Bartz second, Hansen third, and Kim Balint is run out of it at the moment. It's Fagoni from Bartz of America. Hansen, Australia, third. Three there as they hit the bell. Two to qualify, remember. Fagoni looks safe in front, but who's going to qualify second? Bartz is second. Is Hansen going to do it? No, he's not. Hansen just outsped. And it's Fagoni for Italy and Bartz from the USA who go through. And a very fast time, 44.38. The world record is 43.08, held by Mirko Willemann from Italy. And Fagoni there will be mighty impressed with that time. So the qualifiers, Orazio Fagoni from Italy, Randy Bartz from the USA. On to heat number two. Mark Velzebor from the Netherlands, Li Yanjun from China, Kim Ki-hoon from Korea, and Arnaud Drouet from France. And no doubt about the favorite here, Kim Ki-hoon, one of the outstanding skaters of the last couple of years. It's Velzebor on the inside, then Li. There's Ki-hoon. Drouet in lane three, and Ki-hoon on the outside, the Olympic champion. World champion, 500 meters. Four laps to go. Kim at the moment tucked in third place, Velzebor second in front, it's Li. But Kim, as we've seen before, can make his move at any stage. He's not panicking. And now he moves on the inside, takes second from Velzebor. It's Li in front, Kim second, Velzebor third, Drouet at the back, up to the last lap. Still Li, Kim comes on the inside, not able to take it. And very, very close, but he gets through, but only just. And heart in the mouth job there was Li and Kim stretch forward with Velzebor only just behind. Fine heat, and that didn't really go as Kim had planned it. And he might regard himself a little fortunate to have gone through. Just misses out, as does Drouet. On to heat number three, and the reigning world champion, Marc Gagnon for Canada, Li Junho from Korea, Michael McMillan, New Zealand, Patrick Fault from Austria. There's Gagnon, second in the 1500 meters. He's in lane two. On the inside, it's Li for Korea. McMillan on the outside, fork in lane three. And it's Li who makes the first move. Li first, fork in second place, but that's not going to last long. Here comes Gagnon. McMillan leaving himself a lot to do. That's a poor start from McMillan, and he's probably going to pay for that because the two favourites are out and they've gone. Li, the leader, Gagnon second, McMillan trying to get back on terms, but so much work to do, and the start was crucial for him, and he's got a small chance now. Li and Gagnon, not to be headed. They ease up, and McMillan will be disappointed. Fast time again for 45.06. Mm. Lee Junho and Mark Gagnon, the qualifiers there, and it was all over really. And Frederick Blackburn from Canada, the man who trod on Nicky Gooch's skate in the 1500 metres, knocked Gooch out, but he would regard himself as unlucky not to make it through. Yun Uematsu from Japan, there's Freddie Blackburn. Frundel from Germany. There's Uematsu on the outside. So it's Blackburn on the inside. Frundel. Uematsu, and taking his place, late onto the line, Bat Orgil Bachelin from Mongolia. He takes on in two. So it's Blackburn on the inside, then Bachelin, then Frundel, and Uematsu on the outside. So Blackburn goes into this as a slight favourite. No superstars in this particular heat, and it could be one of the closest. Blackburn racing to the first bend and gets the important jump. Blackburn leading from Uematsu. The two of them have opened up a massive gap. Frundel and Bachelin going past in third. But he's going to have good eyesight to look at the first two because they are nearly clear. And provided they don't race it out between the two of them, although Uematsu takes the lead in the last lap. No one out here, although Blackburn looks on the inside, then gives it away. Uematsu wins. Blackburn second. Good race for third, but Frundel takes it. And Bachelin ends up on his backside. But a game effort from the Mongolian. But Uematsu, a comfortable qualifier. He qualifies in first place. Freddie Blackburn qualifies in second. And onto the ice comes this man, Nicky Gooch, desperately unlucky in the 1500 metres in the final. And unlucky, of course, in the Olympics in the 1000 metres, where he was disqualified after looking sure of a silver medal. But he did get bronze in this event, which he would say is his least favourite. He's got so much strength and stamina. But this is a very good heat. Up against him, Eric Flame, the world record holder at 1500, silver medalist outdoors in Calgary in 88, and also Stephen Bradbury from Australia. Igor Kutovoy from Kazakhstan will probably be raced out of this, but two from those three, Flame, Gooch, and Bradbury, it's going to be very difficult. There's Eric Flame on the inside. There's Bradbury, Gooch. Kutovoy. Bad start from Eric Flame. And it may be crucial because Gooch has got the jump on him, and so is Bradbury. And Flame has got a lot to do here. He's going around Kutovoy. He manages that. But it's going to be very different getting past the two in front. Gooch in the lead. Bradbury second. Here comes Flame. Flame does well to get into second. Now can Bradbury counter? It doesn't look like it. Kutovoy taking Bradbury, and I think he ruins Bradbury's chance there, and it looks like Gooch and Flame are through. They take the bell into the last lap. Gooch first, here comes Flame, but there's no need to race it out. The two of them have got it. Nicky Gooch qualifies first, Flame second, and Stephen Bradbury third. But a good time, 45.16, but still the fastest time is that of Fagonis in the first heat. There are the qualifiers. Nicky Gooch, for Great Britain, Eric Flame for the USA. Well, Flame did remarkably well after this start because it looked as if it might have been crucial. There's the stumble, and it made the race mighty difficult for him from then on. Bradbury just checks, and Flame a bad last with half a lap gone, but he made up the ground really well to take second spot. Here's where the race changed. Gooch ticking outside, and here comes Flame on the inner. He showed all his experience through that race, serving him in good stead. Here that Igor Kutavoy has been disqualified, but he was in last place. Kutavoy was disqualified, and you can see just pushing Bradbury wide there, and that really cost Bradbury the race. On to heat six. Choi Ji-hoon from Korea, Martin Johansson, who did really well in the 1500 from Sweden, Jan Hogeveen from Netherlands, and Geert Blanchard from Belgium. A very impressive start. Choi Ji-hoon, the winner of the 1500. Oh, and that's a good move from Johansson. Ji-hoon, the Olympic champion at this distance. But being pressed here, and Johansson taking him on the inside. So it's Johansson first. Choi then. Geert Blanchard to the bell. Now, what's Che going to show us here? Stand by for an electric fine burst of speed. But he doesn't need it. He qualifies quite comfortably in second place. Blanchard pressing, but again, Martin Johansson there in picture, showing what an impressive improvement he's made over the last 12 months. Martin Johansson beating the Olympic champion at this distance. Although Che was not pulling out all the stops, qualifies with ease. Johansson and Choi Ji-hoon, the two qualifiers from heat six. Speed machine here, Mirko Willemann from Italy, the reigning world record holder at this distance. Time of 43.08, and you have to go quick here because he's got two lively contenders with Derek Campbell, who was third in the 1500. There's Willemann, the favourite, on the outside. It's Campbell who's got the jump on Willemann. Campbell leads, Willemann second, it's got to be third. But look at these two, the two of them racing away, Nicholson and Kamko, and these two, within a lap and a half, have done the business. Now there's no need for them, they've got so much speed. There's no need for any histrionics here, but I think Campbell proving a point to Willemann. This will be a fast time, all right? Campbell leads for Willemann. A lap and a half to go. Nicholson third, but he's got no chance. Willemann easing up, letting Campbell move away. Campbell qualifies in a fast time, nearly the fastest so far. It's still held by Fagoni, but that's very good. 44.52, just a second and a half outside Willemann's world record. And I think he was letting Willemann know he's around there. But Willemann goes through with him. So the qualifiers, Campbell, Canada, and Willemann for Italy. So to the final heat of the men's 500. Satoru Tarau from Japan, Richard Nazilski from Australia, Bjorna Elgerton from Norway, Sergei Kopizev from Russia, and Alexander Mikluka from the Ukraine. And the two fancied here are Richard Nazilski from Australia and Bjorna Elgerton, who is the hero of Norway. There he is, Elgerton, who gave the home fans a good run for their money in Lillehammer.
two favourite qualifiers are Elgerton and this man here, Richard Nazilski. But Tarau will have his supporters for sure. There's Nazilski. Kopisev. And Elgerton makes it. Elgerton from Kopisev. Then Nazilski. Tarau is fourth. Is away. Nazilski taking second and Tarau third. Now it should be a battle for the second place because Elgerton looks to have gone. Nazilski second. Oh, Elgerton hits the barrier and that means that Tarau has got his qualification with Nazilski. They can just coast round now this last lap. No problems at all. Kovizev giving chase but he's 15 metres behind and these two will feel themselves mighty lucky. Tarau racing through and I think just snatching the winning qualification berth, but it was academic. 44.97, another good time, but Elgerton will be kicking himself. No wonder those two are laughing because it was a piece of cake for them after the fall, and you can see how disappointed Bjorn Elgerton is. So there's the leading qualifier, Tarau, who just gets the nod in first place, and Richard Nazilski from Australia qualifies with him. And here's the four. Elgerton worked so hard to get to the front and was dominating the race from the front, and then this happened. Just loses his edge, and away he goes. And 500 is his best distance, so you can imagine how disappointed he is. Another look at it. The edge just goes there. And that's a sickening feeling, both physically and mentally. Zilski and Tarau behind at that stage look to have a battle on their hands, but no battle after that. So the lineup, the winner of the 1500 meters, Che Ji Hoon from Korea, Frederick Blackburn from Canada, Richard Nazilski from Australia, and the world record holder at this distance, Mirko Willemann from Italy. So they line up with Nazilski on the inside. Then it's Che, then Blackburn, and Willemann on the outside. No full start this time. Nazilski goes for the inside and Che slips and he's out. Che is out. And no collision, so no restart. Nazilski leads. Willemann second, Blackburn third. Here comes Willemann. Willemann makes his move. A breathtaking move from Willemann. Nazilski still heading out. Blackburn. Willemann leads. Nazilski on the inside. Blackburn third. Willemann wins, Blackburn second, Nazilski third, and out of the competition. Che Ji Hoon, very fast time, 44.10. Just over a second outside his world record, but there's the sorrowful figure of Che Ji Hoon, who doesn't make it through to the semi-final. And Blackburn is probably thankful that he didn't, because Willemann looked untouchable. That was more like it from Willemann. That was more like the speed machine we've heard of. So the second quarterfinal, Derek Campbell of Canada, Jun Uematsu from Japan, Jun Ho Lee from Korea, and Eric Flame, USA. And this, once more, will be very, very tight on the outside.
Go to the start.
Ready? So nobody assured of a place here in the semi-final. And it's helter-skelter to the first bend, but Campbell gets it. Campbell leads from Lee. Uematsu third, and Flame is last. And really, Flame would be looking for better than that. And it's going to be very tough for Eric Flame to make it from there. Campbell leads. Lee, Uematsu, and Flame is struggling. He's going to really find it difficult to make it from there. It's between the top three. Campbell leads. Lee second. Uematsu at the bell. Uematsu tries on the inside and goes. And here comes Flame. Flame gets a really lucky move, crosses over in front of Lee, and Lee looks round. I think he's protesting. Lee is protesting. That was the end of Uematsu, and that gave Flame a big chance. It looks like Flame's got through. Derek Campbell of Canada, Eric Flame from the USA are the qualifiers from the second quarterfinal. Well, we hear that Uematsu has been disqualified. Uematsu from Japan, and that Lee.